Welcome to the FluidSIM video tutorials. This video describes the development and simulation of sequence controls with the GRAFCET in FluidSIM. These are the topics: GRAFCET, the norm; GRAFCET symbols in the standard library; steps, transitions, actions; example of a simple sequence control; GRAFCET, modes of the simulation. The GRAFCET is used for the construction of automated systems, the planning of processes, for commissioning, maintenance, and for the structured teaching of processes in training. The GRAFCET is standardized in EN60848 as a design language. The manufacturer-neutral description of automated processes is part of technical documentation. The GRAFCET is the basis of communication between construction, mechanical engineering, programming, commissioning, operation, and maintenance. The GRAFCET is divided into two parts: the commands to be executed and the structure that maps the chronological sequence of the process. The standard library in FluidSIM contains only a few symbols for the GRAFCET. Steps, transitions, and actions form the core. All special forms of these symbols can be set in the properties dialog. There are symbols for GRAFCET controllers with 8, 16 or 32 inputs and outputs, which are referred to as GRAFCET PLC, for the standard compliant display of the controller and GRAFCET. Electrical circuit and GRAFCET can be displayed separately with the GRAFCET PLC symbol, but simulated at the same time. Processes are divided into steps. Steps are separated from one another by transitions. For a step to become active, the previous step must be active and the following transition condition must be met. At the beginning of a step chain, there is the start step, which is marked with a double frame. The initial step marks the starting position after switching on the control. Steps and transitions must always alternate in the plan. They describe the timing of a process. The actions describe the execution of commands. Actions that have a continuous effect are only active as long as the step associated with them is active. Actions with a saving effect assign variables with saving values. The assigned value can only be changed by another saving action. An example should illustrate the development of a GRAFCET. A double-acting cylinder MM1 of a magazine should extend when the button SF1 is pressed and the cylinder is retracted. If the cylinder is extended, it should retract after pressing a second button, SF2. The electro-pneumatic circuit diagram includes the fluid power circuit, the electrical controls and sensors. Now the GRAFCET is to be created, which describes the process. A step is dragged onto the drawing area and the properties are opened with a double click. The initial step is selected in the drop-down field. Now a transition follows. A name can be assigned in the properties, e.g. extend. It is important to set the condition. In the example, an end operation of the button SF1 and the limit position sensor BG1 is required. The logic operation can be selected using the corresponding button. The dialog for the transition is closed with OK and the settings are accepted. In the following step, the cylinder should extend. This is followed by a transition in which it is checked whether the cylinder is extended and the button, SF2, has been pressed. A double click on the transition opens the properties dialog. The transition can be named, e.g. with retract. The transition condition is the end operation of the end position sensor BG2 and the button SF2. If this condition is met, step 2 is left. If the process is only to be carried out once, a further step is added as a conclusion after the entry transition. If the entry transition is linked to the initial step, the sequence can start again. The drive has a monostable 5/2-way solenoid valve. If a continuously acting action is connected in step 2 that activates the coil MB1, the cylinder is extended as long as step 2 is active. The GRAFCET thus fully describes the desired sequence. FluidSIM has three modes for handling a GRAFCET. These can be preset for the respective sheet, for the respective project, or for FluidSIM as a whole. In the properties of the sheet, the GraphSet treatment can only be set for the sheet. GraphEdit is the pure graphic representation of the process without simulation. During the simulation, only the drive and the respective controller are simulated, but not the GraphSet. GraphView visualizes the GraphSet. The connection programmed control takes over the control. GraphControl simulates the GraphSet. The relay control can be dispensed with. The GraphSet controls the electro-pneumatic power unit. Changes to the GraphSet have a direct effect on the process. If, in the example, a time is built into the transition, retract, instead of the SF2 button, the cylinder remains extended, until the time has elapsed. The waiting time can be observed in the animation of the cylinder, or in the state diagram. Thank you for your attention.